I became a president in spring of 2013, and it was just a couple of years, 5 years or 4 years after the global financial crisis. But it was a time when people had, in a sense, more sanguine feeling about Asian countries. More concretely, when I came to ADB, I felt that this is a more stable conditions of Asian economies, although Europe and America were more affected by the global financial crisis. The Asian growth was very solid, and Sri Lanka conflict was over. Myanmar became more democratized and more market-oriented economy. There were so many positive evolution. Since then, of course, Asia continued to grow in a very solid manner, depending on their domestic demand as well as trade. But in a sense, there are more complicated issues in the global communities. There are some disputes like China-US trade dispute. Brexit is also another uncertainty. There are so many issues related to migrations of the people and politics of countries, including those of developed countries, are not as predicted. So it is becoming more as uncertain, but at the same time, in Asia, I still believe Asia's economy is actually it is growing at the pace of 6% if we exclude more developed countries like Taipei, China, Hong Kong, China, Korea, and Singapore. So economically, it is still okay, and I hope that it will continue to be solid based on the stronger demand from middle class. But how to keep a sense of cooperation, how to keep friendship, how to keep stability in the region is a very important issue, and I hope that ADB will continue to play an important role. We have now 49 regional members, including Australia, New Zealand, Japan. Those are developed countries from the beginning, which never borrowed, but including these three, 49, and 19 non-regional members like America, Canada, and European countries. So they will decide what kind of scale the bank should have. But my own feeling is that Asia is now being more developed, and there is less need of financing big projects by ADB itself. So ADB should play more role of sharing expertise and experiences for doing good work in urban transport, for instance, or environmental issues. And they should play more role of mobilizing more private resources by giving core finance and the private sector feel more comfortable to join those things. Or by promoting PPP projects, by having transaction advisory services, or by giving policy advices to countries together with the policy-based lending. But instead of providing larger finance, I myself feel that it's better to focus more on qualities and knowledge part. Of course, we can have a moderate growth, but if we continue to grow further, in a sense, it is taking a role of private sector, and also it would cause more taxpayers' burden for capital increase. So it's up to the shareholders, but because Asia is now more developed, it's better to focus more on the quality, knowledge, policy advice, and so on. That is my idea.